Good morning. This is the price report number 25 on on-chain and technical analysis. To begin with, I'm going to just mention these two companies. Important to mention Celsius and Three Arrows Capital, which went down, and along with it, it brought down a lot of hard-earned investors' money. With their onslaught, there was also loss in the investor confidence in the overall crypto markets in alternative currencies. And that is the altcoins, and that has also taken a beat on the markets. Today I'm going to discuss about the fear and greed heat map, talk about the on-chain data, which are the four indicators mentioned on the screen, and the technical analysis. So I want to basically point out where we are in the market structure and where we might be heading. So this is the fear and greed heat map, which shows how oversold or overbought are we. The green indicates highly agreed indication of the heat map, and right now we are at oversold territory. With 19,000, we were at the all-time lows, pretty much historically speaking. So we are at an oversold territory as we speak. We are not 100% sure if we are going to go further down, but looks like the selling pressure has exhausted for the moment. So I'm going to move to the on-chain analysis, the indicators, the first one of which is the 200-week moving average heat map. So what you see here, the long-term trend line is the 200-week moving average, currently sitting about 22,300. And historically, broadly speaking, this has held during all the past bear markets. And this is also a key level to watch for the technical traders and the long-term investors, some of who will be willing to allocate capital at this level due to the perceived importance as a bottom signal. So right now we are at these levels. We went down to 17,000, we bounced back, and we are again flirting around these levels. So this is the price. This is the 22,300 is the price to watch, and I see that we are around those levels currently. The next one in line is the MVRVZ ratio. This signal that you see here is the Z ratio, which shows heavily oversold territories in the past. So whenever we enter the green territory, shows that we in the market are heavily oversold, especially about the Bitcoin. That's what I'm talking about right now. And this marks the key areas of uncertainty. You would see that this also happened during the March 2020 pandemic crash. And this has happened several times in the past during the bear markets. And this indicator is also very important to help manage the emotions of the long-term investors to know where we are in the market cycle. The next one in line I would talk about is the realized price, which is basically, again, the long-term trend line between the one that you see in the price is the market price of Bitcoin, and the one below is the realized price. And you'd see, except for the March 2020 crash, the market price went above the realized price quite immediately. But in all the other bear markets in the past that we have seen, we have sustained below this orange line for many months. So let's say, for example, we take 2015, it was between January and November. So almost for a year, we were under this line. So the current climate of the stock markets and the geopolitical situation is not favorable. So I would draw analogies from the past of 2015 and also the 18 bear markets. In this case, we were down for, again, for almost 8 months. And I would say that for the coming months, we would be flirting around these levels. In fact, below this orange line, which is tending to go up over time. So I see ourselves around these price levels. And what is also happening here is it's a game of patience for the coming months. And also a patience for the Bitcoin miners, because a lot of Bitcoin miners hold a lot of Bitcoins currently. And Bitcoin price is about 20,000 right now. There are electricity costs which they have to pay off. And it's quite logical to think that some miners might be struggling and may go even out of business. So what do they do to kind of avoid this? They sell Bitcoins to survive. which adds to further sell pressure into the markets. So while talking about Bitcoin miners, we have to talk about the pool multiple, which is a representation of the miners' revenues versus the historical trends or benchmarks. And it just happened so in, I think, the beginning of June, that it has alerted us into the green zone, which is a pure indication of the miners going under maximum stress in terms of their revenues. This has also happened in the past and it's not new. And this typically happens whenever the Bitcoin price is in its lower state, not also bottoming out around these regions. So when the miners capitulate. So we would see, I would show you in one of the next charts, the miners have not yet completely capitulated. So it might be something that is coming. And I've also seen other indicators to find out where will the sell pressure be exhausted. And I find those levels to be about 15,500 to 16,000 levels. Again, I'm not saying that we're going that low, but that is the place where the sell pressure will be completely exhausted. And that could be the result of a capitulation around those levels. And I don't see that coming in the next few days, because right now the markets are taking a breather. But this whole study that I'm showing right now is only a probability to base our decisions for long-term investment. Now I'm going to come to the technical analysis. Nothing much interesting to show, because in this bear market, the on-chain charts do the talking by itself. But we see, last time I did show that although we are doing down an RSI, so there is a possibility of a rally to 25,000-ish levels, where I see some kind of resistance. And then 30,000 is really, really big resistance. We do see miners capitulating. So they might actually take the opportunity, if and when Bitcoin touches 25,000 or, you know, even goes towards 30,000, they might be selling. So they might be the sellers in the market. So this is something to keep an eye on. The next thing is the Bitcoin dominance. It's been flirting around 40% to 50%. And I do see, as money flows from the altcoins to Bitcoins due to lack of the consumer sentiment, sorry, investor sentiment, it's going to increase slightly the Bitcoin dominance. And a couple of more things about the Monero's dominance. Currently, we are sitting around 0.24. I think we're just going to follow the trend of Bitcoin in the overall bear market. But with interest peaking in, also the all-time transactions being at all-time high, I do see this picking up steam a little bit, but it might be a game of patience. And another thing to point out, which was a bit concerning, that the Monero's average daily transaction volumes on exchanges have been about $180 million for the last 6 months on average, plus minus. And it's dropped down to double digits, about 60 to 70 million for the last week or so. And this could certainly be because of the overall bear markets in place and people, not trying to trade that much on the exchanges. So that could potentially bring down the volumes. But we also see that the transactions are pretty much at all-time highs if you even see in the last 1 year or 3 years, it's pretty much peaking. So the interest is growing over time. But one of my hypotheses earlier was this transaction from the beginning of June, when the tail emission started, we also had like the drop down in prices. So people could be moving their coins across to exchanges for selling. And the recent price pump that we saw from less than $100 to $120 could also be because of purchasing and moving coins back to the wallet. So it's not completely clear at the moment. So we have to wait and watch for the next couple of weeks to see where this trend goes. The average transactions per day for this year has been about 22,000. So I'm happy to see this growing, but I could also see that this comes down to about 25,000 in the coming days or weeks. But if this keeps on going up, then I would be proven wrong. And that is all from my side for this week's price report, and I hope you learned something from it. I wish you all a great day ahead.